Well, if the children would like to come forward, I believe it's time for our children's story. If you have any of those green things in your pockets with numbers on them, we would like to have the children read those out and bring them forward. Is, you know, you get in the back. Well, it was interesting because he came into, and he was a very busy man, it was the summertime, and he came into the driveway from around the corner, and his wheels were turned, and he parked it in the driveway, and he left the key in the truck. And we had a wonderful little boy next door. His name was Butch O'Brien, and he used to say to us, what he used to say? He said something like, "Don't mess with me, my dad's Marty O'Brien. My dad's," he would say that again. Which also had a habit of, when he would get off his bicycle, he would just do like Saturday Night Live. He didn't put his feet down, he just went on his side. But it was a short bicycle, he was a short kid, like 4 years old, 5 years old. My sister was about five, yeah, they were about five. They knew enough to know what to do about a truck. So dad's in the house, the truck pulls up, and Butch and my sister Beth decide, let's get in the truck. Let's get in the front seat of the truck, which I guess would be okay, but it was a stick truck. And somehow, I think because the driveway was flat, I am never going to know whether Dad left it in gear or not. Because they would have had to know how to push the clutch and take it out of gear. So I'm thinking, anyway, they pushed the button. Butch pushed the button. I guess it was Butch or it was Beth. We're never going to know that part either.
Well,
so,
the person who started it, their name started with a
V. That'll be an elimination question. That's true. In heaven, when all secrets are found out, we will know. So, anyway, the truck, because he had the wheels cranked, it went out of the driveway and backed up, thank the Lord, into a tree in our yard. Because we lived on a road, but the next road over was like busy, and dogs used to get killed on the road, people got hit on the road. Anyway, it stopped there like that. And Dad heard the crash. He came out and he looked, and there's Butch and Beth in the truck, and he got them out of the truck. Of course, Butch ran home. Butch ran home, but Beth was left behind, and Dad came in the house, and my brother and I were in the house, and we didn't even know what happened. But I think Beth got a spank. In those days, parents used to not make you stand in corners. We had quick punishments. It was over fast. And once it was over, you cried and you could forget about it. But now, you know, you gotta think, what did I do wrong for 5 minutes? Anyway, in those days, Dad sat down and he said, come on over here. And Beth, he bent her over me and he gave her 1, 2, 3 whacks. And then he said to Denny and I, he said, and you took him over here too. And we went, but Dad, we didn't do anything. He said, get over here. And he gave him 3 whacks. 1, 2, 3. And we stood up and we said, bags. And he said, in case you ever think about doing anything like that. And I want you to know, I have never thought about doing anything like that again. I got up and I cried and I thought, oh, my sister could have been killed. Butcher could have been killed. Oh, I'm so thankful the tree was there. And we were all happy. We got a spanking. We were happy we got a spanking. Well, in Revelation chapter 19, in this King James Version, it uses a big word for when you get, you know, somebody tells you did something wrong. And it uses the word chasten. And it's not a funny word. It means you're getting scolded, you're getting bawled out, you're getting told, don't do that. And it says, as many as I, oh, by the way, why do you think my dad gave us that spanking? Because he was so hated us? Did he hate us? What do you think? Did my dad hate us or did he, what? Loved us. Oh, that could be possible too. But you know what? It's because he loved us and he didn't want to lose us to some crazy accident. And so he gave us a bad scolding and we got a spanking and we never forgot it. The Bible says, as many as I love, I rebuke. In other words, I tell you and I chasten, might include a spanking. And be zealous, therefore, and repent. And my sister grew up to be a wonderful person. She never did anything wrong after that. Well, we can hope, can't we? So let's have a prayer and thank the Lord for when Jesus tells us to do something, or our grandma or our grandpa or our parents tells us to do something, big sister, little sister, we know that God loves us, right? Can you say amen?
Amen.
All right. Dear Lord, thank you so much for these precious children. And may we always remember that when you give us our scolding, or our parents, or our grandparents, or our big brother, or big sister, it's because they love us. They want to keep us out of trouble, and they want us to be safe. In Jesus' name we thank you. And everybody say,
amen. Amen.